end of the Cretaceous. 66 million years ago, the planet was a paradise. The Flower Revolution had created a vibrant, high-energy world. The dinosaurs were at their absolute peak, diverse, intelligent, and dominant. Reptiles ruled the land, the sky, and the sea. And our ancestors, the mammals, were tiny, nocturnal, and irrelevant. This world had existed for 165 million years. It seemed it would last forever. They had no idea that this was the last day. Because 400 million miles away, a 6-mile-wide mountain of rock was about to keep its appointment. This is the Earth Journey. It had traveled for millions of years, its orbit set. It was moving at 40,000 miles per hour, 20 times faster than a speeding bullet. On Earth, the dinosaurs would have seen it. A new star, getting brighter and brighter. It was not going to miss. Its target, a shallow tropical sea in what is now the Yucatan Peninsula, Mexico. The last day had ended. The next few minutes would change the planet forever. This is the moment of impact. The asteroid was so fast, it vaporized the ocean before it even touched it. It strikes with the force of 10 billion Hiroshima bombs. A hole 100 miles wide and 20 miles deep is punched into the Earth's crust in 2 seconds. The asteroid itself is vaporized. Gone. Trillions of tons of superheated rock, water, and sulfur are blasted directly into space. A ring of pure, white-hot energy expands at thousands of miles per hour. The blast wave is the loudest sound in Earth's history. Anything within 1,000 miles is instantly incinerated. Forests and dinosaurs are gone. The impact triggers mega earthquakes, magnitude 12, all over the planet. It shakes the planet so hard, volcanoes on the other side of the world erupt violently. The water that was blasted out now rushes back in. A wave 1,000 feet tall, a mega tsunami, washes over the Gulf of Mexico. It travels hundreds of miles inland, destroying everything in its path. But this was not the true killer. For the T-Rex in Montana, the horror was just beginning. This is the real killer. The trillions of tons of rock blasted into space did not escape. Gravity pulled it right back down. All over the world, 30 minutes later, the sky began to fill with shooting stars. Not shooting stars. Trillions of tiny glass beads re-entering the atmosphere. As they re-entered, they heated up from friction. The entire sky, everywhere on Earth, began to glow red hot. The atmosphere became a broiler, a 1,000-degree overhead oven. The T-Rex, 9 tugs, had nowhere to hide. It was cooked alive from the air itself. The Triceratops, the Hadrosaurs, all of them collapsed and died. The pterosaurs in the sky were incinerated instantly. And then, the forests, the giant Cretaceous forests all over the world, ignited. The planet was on fire. After a few hours, the sky broiler faded. But the damage was done. The giants were dead.
But, Bopuovan, but what about the oceans?
The mega tsunami had scoured the coasts. The heat from the broiler had boiled the surface of the ocean. The giant marine reptiles, the mosasaurs, the plesiosaurs, they were gone. The ammonites, the shelled creatures, gone. The world was burning. But the worst was yet to come. The fires and the impact had thrown trillions of tons of soot and ash into the sky. The sky was black. Not red. Black. The sun was blotted out. This was the beginning of the impact winter. Without sunlight, the planet began to freeze. A world of fire was about to become a world of ice. Photosynthesis stopped. Globally. The plants that survived the fire now died in the dark and the cold. In the ocean, the plankton, the base of the food chain, died. The entire global food web had collapsed. For years, the world was a frozen, dark wasteland. But the apocalypse had one more gift. The sulfur blasted from the impact site mixed with the water in the clouds. It began to rain concentrated sulfuric acid. The acid poisoned whatever small lakes and rivers were left. A burnt, frozen, and acidic world. The final toll, 75% of all species on Earth were gone. The T-Rex, gone. The Triceratops, gone. The pterosaurs, gone. The giant marine reptiles, gone. The dinosaurs were extinct. The dinosaurs were extinct.
A small caveat, well, almost all of them.
One small lineage of feathered dinosaurs had already evolved into birds, and some of them survived.
Yes, dinosaurs are still here,
We just call them birds.
But who else survived?
The killer came from the sky. The survivors came from the underground.
Our ancestor, the mammal.
Why did it survive?
One, it was underground, safe from the 1,000 degree sky broiler.
Two, it was warm-blooded. It could survive the cold.
Three, it was small. It needed almost no food.
And four, its food source survived. It ate insects and seeds, which were buried in the soil. Nile crocodiles, leatherback turtles, they survived. Goliath frogs, salamander amphibians, they survived.
Anything big and on the surface had no chance.
After years of darkness, the sun returned.
The fern spike. The first plant to recolonize the dead world. The world was a world of ferns and fungus.
And our ancestor stepped out into the sunlight. It looked around. The T-Rex was gone. The raptors were gone.
The 165 million year reign of terror was over.
The world was empty, a blank slate waiting to be claimed. And this time, our ancestors would not be hiding.
The story of how our ancestors took over the world.
And became monsters of their own.
Point is the next step in our journey.
The age of dinosaurs
ended in fire.
A global broiler cooked the giants.
A global winter starved the survivors.
But in the darkness, a new ruler was waiting.
The age of reptiles was over. The age of mammals had begun.
The Earth Journey.
If you want to continue this journey through time, subscribe to The Earth Journey.
Our story is just beginning.